Hello world, and welcome back to Final Fantasy X! It's been a few days since I actually recorded anything, but we did a few things and we boosted up our characters. I came back to this spot to continue from where we left off last time, but I did a little bit of training, not a whole lot, but let's see if I can find it. As you can see down here, Yuna has learned the level 3 black magic abilities. Waka has continued on his path and completely completed his sphere grid. Orin has done the same. In fact, Waka and Orin have kind of crossed paths, and I'm taking them down each other's path instead to boost Orin's accuracy, more or less, and to boost Waka's strength and HP. I figured that's a good trade-off. Titus is slowly getting there. He learned Quick Hit and Entrust, which is an absolute amazing ability if you're not cheating or anything, but still pretty good in a very tight situation. Riku, I wish she was better. I'm going to keep her in the active party as much as I can. I'm not going to switch her out. We pretty much went over Lulu. Basically, she's learned the level 3 spells, but we're not quite where we want her to be yet. Kimari's getting there while learning Flare, so that's pretty nice. Let's check out his stats real quick. If Kimari's magic is pretty good, it is not horrible. It's on par with Waka's, so it can't be that bad. But yeah, I boosted up everyone's stats, gave them new abilities and stuff like that, so yeah, that's pretty much where we're at right now. So anyway, our next destination is Mount Gagazet, and that's right back up here, and we're also due for a couple cutscenes from Yuna. Thankfully, they're very short. At least the first one is. So let's go up here, cross this bridge. I got the nagging feeling there's something I'm forgetting. I don't think there is. I'm pretty sure we completed everything we possibly could in the Calmlands at this point in the game. We'll probably be back. Also, before I forget, let's see. Make sure to keep these catcher weapons for... I've got it for Waka, Orin, and Titus. It doesn't matter who you get them for, as long as you keep them, because we're going to be capturing fiends just as well in Mount Gagazet. I'm going to show off where and how to capture those fiends. Anyway, come up here and cutscene.
Sometimes Yuna would just stare off into the distance. I finally understood why. She was saying goodbye to the places she'd never see again.
And here we are on the cold mountains of Mount Gagazet. And I wish I saved my ice puns for now. Anyway, we'll keep going up this hill, and we finally run into where all the Ronto have been hiding, more or less.
Summoner Yuna and Guardians, leave here at once. Gagazet is Ronso land, sacred mountain of Yevon. The mountain will not bear the footsteps of infidels.
Enemy of Yevon is enemy of Ronso! Leave, traitors!
I have cast aside Yevon. I follow the temple no more.
Then you will die by those words.
So be it. Yevon has warped the teachings and betrayed us all.
Nothing but a bunch of low-down tricksters, eh?
Yeah!
We have no regrets.
Blasphemers!
A summoner and her guardians.
Lord Kel'Gronso, if I may. Have you not also turned your back on Bavel?
But still, you guard Gagazet as a Ronso, not a maester. Yuna is much the same.
Huh? Elder Kelk! Let Biron rend them asunder! No escape! Not one!
No, we will not flee. We will fight and continue on.
You have been branded a traitor, but still you would fight sin? Lost to the temple, hated by the people, yet you continue your pilgrimage? Everything lost, what do you fight for?
I fight for Spira. The people long for the calm. I can give it to them. It's all I can give. Defeating sin, ending pain. This I can do.
Even sacrificing yourself. Ronso, let them pass. Summoner Yuna, your will is stronger than steel. Tempered steel that even the mightiest Ronso could not hope to bend. Yuna, we bow to your will. Now go. The sacred heights of Gagazet welcome you.
We thank you.
What the crap are Titus and Waka doing back there? Okay, so here we are back on Gagazet. You can talk to your party members. It's nothing really new that we haven't heard before. Waka points out that Xanarkin is on the other side. Riku's trying to think of ways to save Yuna. Yuna's willing but scared. Lulu's worried. Kimari's worried about a different situation. We'll get to that in a second. And Orin just wants to go over the mountain. I don't think there are any Albed primers on this mountain. At least not in this... I think we're at the summit? Oh no, Mountain Gate. But if you talk to this female Ronso here, I believe... Nope, talk to this guy Ronso? Yeah, talk to him. He'll sell you weapons and items. And... again, they're nothing too great, except they do have strength and magic plus 10%, and an additional empty slot, which means we can do whatever we want to that. I don't know if I would recommend buying anything here. You know what? In this playthrough, I'm going to go ahead and buy the Barak Sword for Titus. I'll put on plus 5% strength and sensor, only because Water Strike is not really useless at this point, but he's going to be a hindrance more than anything when I really need him. And at least this way I don't have to worry about his weapon for a while. I know we have his celestial weapon, and we're going to get his crest soon enough. It's just between here and then, it's going to be a struggle unless I get him something good. So we'll go ahead and equip. Yuna... I don't know, because we have the same issue with her. We have her weapon, we have her crest, but we don't have her sigil yet. It's going to take some time, but I think I'm going to hold off on actually doing anything with her. I want to buy this for him, but I know evade encounter is better, so I might not. Yeah, I'm gonna skip on Lulu as well because she'd only be getting like a plus 5% magic increase, and we can get something better for her in a bit. We could add something to Kamari. I'm not entirely sure what, but I think we're good with him. Auron could definitely use something better. Let's buy that. Riku, I'm almost certain she gets something better soon enough, so we'll skip that. I think we'll keep that for Titus, because I like magic counter. We'll keep that for Yuna. I know we could add on the proofs instead of ward, but eh. I know, I'm gibberish. I'm speaking gibberish. We'll go ahead and buy this for Riku. We'll equip it. I think it's because there's something we might be able to give her armor, and it'll go pretty well with a weapon that's coming up, I believe. I'm probably wrong. Again, if you don't have the money, I would not recommend buying anything. At least not yet. If you have the extra gil to spend, by all means, go right ahead. I just can't imagine you'd have anything after the whole Yojimbo thing. Okay, so what can we add? Oh, we can't add plus 5%. Ew, I kind of made a mistake. Well, only kind of. We can still make this work. The thing is, if all we add is sensor, then that's only a 5% strength loss. And if we add strength plus 3, that's only 2%. But let's see what other abilities we have before I do anything. Because I definitely feel like I want sensor. Why not? We could add piercing. But I don't know. We could add strike abilities. That's always a thought. Death strike. Oh, that's right, the far plane winds. Yeah, I believe you can add either death ward or death proof and onto your armor and death strike onto your weapons. It's that, again, that's pretty awesome. Just not every enemy is affected by death, and even more so, you won't get any overkills if death strike or death touch works. So it's good, but not the greatest. Yeah, let's go ahead and put in the strength plus 3% just to balance out his strength. And we'll keep it there. For Auron, now this is a tough one too. I might do counterattack just because of his abilities. It will take up a friend spear, but we'll get more of those along the way. So we'll go ahead and add that. The only reason why I'm not doing evade encounter, which actually I probably could have. Yeah, we'll do counterattack because he has the overdrive ability Rook, and that means whenever he takes damage, and say he has a protect on him when he does it, it'll be added onto his overdrive gauge. Now, we don't have auto protect, so that's not the greatest right now, but it can be good later on, and especially if we just cast protect on him, it won't be bad. Let's give him a sensor just because. And let's see for Riku. Yeah, about what I said earlier, I think I might be wrong because I can't actually remember what the ability was. But it seems we don't even have the item for, or the, yeah, we don't have the items for it. Because it's not showing up on the list. I forgot what it was. I'm probably wrong, so I kind of wasted money. But on the other hand, it's good we got something slightly better for Riku, so I can't complain. The only thing I would maybe suggest. Actually, no. We'll keep that for Riku. Why not? Okay. So go ahead and talk to this guy again to buy some items. And what you need to buy in particular is holy water. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and buy like 99 of each. I figured why not, because I'm almost there anyway. At this point, even after the Yojimbo thing and after gaining money just by training, you'll probably have enough to buy 99 of each. At the very least, the 50 gil costing ones like Antidote, Eye Drops, Echo Screen Softs. But the reason you want Holy Water is because it cures Zombie and Curse. Not so much for the former, but definitely for the latter. There's no real way to heal Curse except for Holy Water, as far as I know. They might have made it so Asuna cures it in this version, but I don't recall that being a thing. Anyway, when you think you're all ready, and I'm pretty sure we are... Oh, and before you even begin, if you haven't done so already, go back and thoroughly train Kimari. He's going to have one boss fight coming up, one versus two, and if he is not... I want to say if he's not at this particular level right here, like for his strength and everything else, he's not going to be the greatest, and it's going to be difficult to win. And another thing is, if you take him down Orin's path like I usually do, you'll have no problem. However, there is another thing where I think the boss fight scales with Kimari. So it's like, however well you train Kimari, the boss fight will be trained just as well. I could be wrong, but I did a playthrough where I cheated 100%, and I got Kimari to, like, complete his sphere grid by this point. And I remember those two being, like, uber powerful. Like, their HP and just everything about them was so much more than what they usually are. But, anyway... I don't think there's anything else you can do. You can check out some of the Ronzo stats, because I think these are the Ronzo fangs? Maybe I'm wrong? Nope, I am wrong. Okay, I don't know what I'm talking about. apologies. Anyway, when you're ready, go over to the save sphere. Save into a new slot. And go right up here for the next cutscene slash boss fight.
Haven't you bothered us enough?
Summoner may pass. Guardians may pass. Kimari not pass! Kimari shame, Ronso brothers. Kimari forget his birth.
Forget his people, forget his mountain. Little Ronso, weakling Ronso.
Mountain hate the weak, hate the small. If you will climb,
then I must prove my strength.
Think you will win? You not forget who took your horn. Never forget.
Kimari never beat Brother Biran. Never win.
This time, I win. I will win.
Why, you... This some kind of Ronso thing?
Kimari problem.
Biran, rend you asunder!
Hornless! Hornless!
So here we are in the boss fight against Biran Ronso and Yenki Ronso. These guys are not easy. I lost to them a lot when I was younger. But as you can see, they have quite amount of HP, and I think that goes into what I said before. Depending on how you train Kimari, these guys will be trained just as well. The cool thing about them is, if you happen to use Lancet on one of them, you start gaining their abilities. However, as you're starting to see, yeah, they also have a lot of abilities to use against you, and they don't have an overdrive. That means they can just spam them as they will. So to start off the battle, just keep using Lancet until you learned everyone's abilities. All the while, your turn will come up faster, and you damage them by draining HP. Not so much MP because you haven't used any yet, but it's a pretty good way to start off the fight. Now they are going to use Aqua Breath, Fire Breath. They're not going to use Thrust Kick. I don't think they're going to use Doom. But they do use a few abilities here and there, and it's nothing to worry about on the one hand. On the other hand, it's never a bad thing to be too safe. They'll also use Black Magic abilities as well, but they don't do a whole lot of damage. Just keep using Lancet until you've basically learned everything you can. But you're not done with Lancet just yet. They're going to keep using those abilities. Now, the best thing I would recommend doing after you've learned as many abilities as you can... Right, I haven't learned it yet. Never mind. Forget what I was going to say. We do have Scan and Dispel. There's a good reason we learned Dispel. And you'll see why in just a short amount of time. Anyway, the best thing you can really do is go ahead and steal or mug from one or the other. And the only way to do this is when you have this exact setup. When one Ronso is on one side and the other is on the other. Because if I were to attack Buran while he's next to Yankee, attacking Buran will make Yankee take the hit. And I don't recall if you successfully steal or not. When they're separated, you'll deal more damage. When they're together, the other will block the target, and your damage will be reduced. So let's go ahead and mug Buran. Level 3 Key Sphere. Not entirely bad. Let's go ahead and mug the other. Level 3 Key Sphere. I can't speak. And it looks like they're still separate, so that's not bad. But Kamari is starting to take a beating. I think we'll manage. He doesn't really know anything useful. That's the only downside. But we've been doing quite a bit of damage, so let's go ahead and attack. Not bad for 1,000 per swing. He'll go down fairly easy. Okay, Kamari is pretty weak at this point. I wouldn't entirely recommend it, but go ahead and use an X potion if you have it. Actually, no. Use High Potion because he doesn't need to be at full health. But I'm sure you've gathered enough X potions by now to more than supply Kamari with enough HP. You can also use Mega Potions if you need to, and that'll be just as nice. Alright, let's go ahead and keep attacking Yankee. I forgot which one has what ability, but they've got a few nice ones coming up. Okay, we might have to use a Mega Potion after all. So let's go ahead and use one. Again, it's kind of useless with only one person, but you can't beat 2,000 HP if there's no other way you can heal. For right now, let's use luck. Why not? We can't do much at this point anyway, until they're separate. And there we go. Okay, let's go ahead and... Actually, you know what? Yeah, let's go ahead and use Fire Breath. Why not? Not bad, over 2,000 damage.
This is the strength of Kimari.
Mighty Guard, that's what we were looking for. Although it does kind of suck he's using it, it's good that he uses it, because that means as soon as he uses that ability, we can steal it, more or less. And that gives us a full overdrive once again. Let's go ahead and dispel him while we're at it. There we go. And when our turn comes up next, we're going to go ahead and use Mighty Guard just to keep us a little more protected. Ronso Rage, Mighty Guard, and this works for your whole party too. So if you had more than just Kamari and you use Mighty Guard, it affects everyone, which is really nice. It's probably one of the better abilities in the game. There's something a lot better than that, I'll admit, but that's neither here nor there. Let's just... Actually, Let's use Flare, see how well that works. Nice, and we even got the overkill.
You will pay for this.
Yeah, bite me. And that's a bad thing. He's gonna use Haste, so we gotta dispel that right away. Let's go ahead and do that. And now that Flare is our best friend, this is gonna be fun. Okay, he's just gonna spam Haste, so I don't think we have a choice. I want to say he had another ability, but... eh. Let's just Flare him, why not? That's doing pretty good damage, more than his physical attack. Ah, but yeah, that hurt. Oh, this is gonna hurt too. Why does he have three oh, wait. Right, the thing about Flare is, it's powerful, but it has a pretty nasty kickback. It makes you... it basically makes your turn come up slower, so you can't use it all the time. Let's go ahead and use another Mega Potion. That should keep us hanging in there, just barely. And if we use another Flare, that might straight up kill him, so let's go for it. And it worked! Nice!
You win.
Now, I think you could steal more things from either of the Ronsos, or you could learn another ability from Yankee. I'm probably wrong about that. I thought he had, like, Doom or something, but I think we can learn that later on anyway, so... anyway, that's it for that battle, and we win 4 Return Spheres. Alright, that actually gives us back some of the ones we've used before.
Strong is Kimari. Biron is happy. Sacred Mount Gagazet. I honor the name of strong warrior who defeats Biron. Remember always, Gagazet, that name is Kimari. Mountain knows Kimari strong. Kimari may pass. Summoner, we Ronso will stop pursuers from temple.
Truly?
Penance for breaking Kimari's horn long ago. We crush enemies following behind. Kimari crushed enemies standing before. You are most fortunate, summoner.
I thank you.
Ronso will shine your statue brightest.
Thank you. But I fear that no one will make a statue for a traitor such as I am.
Then Ronso will make. With Grand Horn on head.
That would be wonderful.
I wanted to see Yuna's statue too, but I wanted to see it with Yuna by my side.
Spoilers, that statue is never made for Yuna. Now again, you can come back and hit the save sphere if you want. Let's see, does he really... yeah, let's go back and we'll just use it. We won't save, but we'll just tap it. Just tap it in. There we go. Also, you noticed we can't play Blitzball. That option is actually grayed out, I believe, from this point on until we beat Xanarkand. But when you're ready, head up towards the mountain. And I don't think there's any treasures or anything, so we'll keep going for another cutscene.
Summoner Yuna!
What is it this time?
Noble name, no. Rey and me.
Once again, another cutscene that I don't frankly understand why it was separate from the previous one. Anyway, is Riku in our party? No, she is not. Let's go ahead and keep her in the party, like I said. And we'll just keep heading along the path. This is going to be a very long trek, and quite a few enemies. Some of them we might have seen before, others we may have only seen, like, relatives of. But as you can see here, we have two Gratz and a Bashura. Key thing to note, they're all weak against fire. And these plants especially are absorbing, or... No, that's not absorbing, that's nullifying water. So if you kept Titus's Brotherhood sword and put him in this battle, he will be completely useless. And that is just not okay. So I think, wow, what happened? So I think what we're going to do is have Riku probably just steal from the Bashura, see what he has. Soul Spring, okay. Yuna is going to test out her fire magic and see how much damage she can do. Almost max damage, that is nice. Okay, let's see what Orin can do against the big guy. Max damage, alright! I'm sorry, I'm excited about that. That means Orin is fully the tank we need him to be. Now, I know what I said before, that I'm not going to search out Riku. I changed my mind already. We are going to go ahead and steal from the plant. Antidote. Eh. Launches a sea cannon. Well, I took it. Not bad. Okay, now, like before, with any enemy that we fought just similar to him before, when he puts his arms up, he's gonna counterattack when we attack, so we gotta be careful. Let's see how much damage Waka can do. Nice! I'm so glad I trained, they're doing so much more damage. Okay, Titus, I'm hoping he won't kill this guy. I don't think he will. Does not, but that's great damage. And that is a great counterattack. Alright. We'll bring in Lulu. And she will... Oh yeah, we also learned Bio, which... There's actually a strategy for an upcoming boss fight I want to try out.
I hope you like it hot.
Cast Fire and... Overkill for nearly max. I think she and Yuna are weak... equal now. Alright, so we're... Our whole party is in pretty good standing, and I am liking it. Of course, I had to grind a lot, so the experience isn't going to be that great, but we'll take it. Now, there's no real reason to do this other than added cutscene slash story, but let's pray at this thing.
These mark the graves of summoners and guardians who failed.
Now, I think in the original international version, forgive me, I said pray, I meant just talk to it, basically. Interacting with this will trigger a fiend fight to represent those who have fallen at these, I guess, grave markers? That doesn't happen here, so, yeah. And we have two new enemies again, two mech defenders and a mech leader. Same as before, nothing to worry about, just go ahead and attack. Nice overkill. I think that was a critical. So just have Waka attack. Did not kill, but still pretty good damage. We'll cast Thundergun. And nice overkill. Now the thing to note is you basically want to kill probably the electrocutioner or mech leader. I'm sorry, I messed up. Kill the mech leader because of his ability electrocutioner. It does pretty moderate damage, though it is thunder based. So you could cast, I think it's shock? I'm sorry, what was the ability? I forgot. Null shock. Wow. I'm dumb. Cast null shock and you won't have to worry about it. It's the other guys that you definitely want to worry about because they can do pretty decent damage. We'll just have Yuna guard. And this... yeah. I didn't get everyone in the party like I should've. I forgot Waka's evade encounter. Still, I'll take what I can get. Keep going along the path. And there's really not much to say. It's just really cold in this area. And it's a really long-winded path. We've seen this before, so we'll be right back. So yeah, this path is just really long. And it's going to take a while to even get to the next safe sphere. So this might be a pretty long episode. And we have here a Bandersnatch.
Ugh.
I'm sorry, every time I read the word Bandersnatch, I think back to Resident Evil Code Veronica. And there was an enemy there that scared the crap out of me when I was a kid. Ugh. We also have a Nidhogg. We might have seen him earlier. And another mech leader. So, like any wolf, we'll go ahead and kill it. Nice overkill. Yeah, that kind of hurt. And Titus is low on HP. Wow. Ornn will go ahead and kill. I'm going to have Lulu heal. She hasn't learned Kirega, neither has Yuna, but we're slowly getting there. Let's see. We'll have Kamari come in. Then probably Riku, Yuna, then Waka. And hit attack. Sorry for I didn't say it. Oh, that's right, he had counterattack. How did I forget my tank is a tank? Oh well, sorry Waka. We'll do him and apparently Titus a favor. We'll keep them in the front lines for now. There we go. Anyway, we'll keep going right up here and we should find a safe, well not safe sphere, but a Jix sphere. Or rather a Braska sphere, you know what I mean. Details from the journey taken 10 years prior. We'll go ahead and take a look, obviously.
Hello, Yuna. I hope you are well. I wonder how old you are now that you're watching this sphere. You must be very beautiful, like your mother. I wish I could see you. Oh, by the way, Jekt and Ornn send their regards. So far, our journey has been very entertaining. Of course, it is a hard journey, but I have no regrets. It is the path I have chosen. Yuna, when you have grown, you will have to find your own path. Do what you must do the way you want to do it. Doors will always open themselves to those who do. Listen close, Yuna. Your future is yours to make. Live the way you want to. Whatever way that may be, you have your father's full support. Yuna, I will always be with you.
Two things to know. We'll start with the obvious. Ornn has learned a new overdrive, Banishing Blade. Now what that does is, it's a cool animation, I'll give it that, but it can also inflict full break on an enemy, and that is very nice. The only thing is, we can already learn full break at some point. It just, full break costs like 99 MP or something like that, I forgot the exact amount. It costs more MP than Ornn really has in reserves, so you can either use that, or you can use Banishing Blade, which has like no MP usage. However, it does require a full overdrive. So it's kind of do one or the other depending on the situation, but it's still very nice. The other thing to note is Braska was an awesome father. It's not that he didn't want Yuna to be a summoner, more so he wanted her to choose her own path. And that is something that's really awesome, all things considered. Usually father figures like that would make them choose the same path. And here we are with one new enemy, a grenade. Same as bombs and others before that, attack it 3 times, it'll blow up in your face, so you gotta be careful. Let's just go ahead and attack these plants. Get out of here, plants. We don't need ya. This might not overkill, but oh well. And I don't think the bombs are... They're weak to ice, but I think their magic defense is pretty high. Let's go ahead and... Whoa. Get down there, Mike. Let's go ahead and use Blizzica.
Icing on the cake.
Let's see. Does not kill. Has really high magic defense, apparently. Either that or Lulu's magic just isn't that strong. One or the other. We'll send Riku in. This might be risky, but I'm going to go ahead and steal, or rather, mug. 3 fire gems. I can make do with that. So one more hit, and we are kind of screwed. Again, this is another risky play because Orin has counterattack, which means if that plant attacks Orin, we're... The whole party won't get experience, so let's go for it. Overkill, nice. Okay, the plant is going to attack in 2 more turns, so we got a chance. Let's bring in Kimari, he's just going to mug. And we'll have Yuna finish the battle. At least she'll get an overkill. I think. Hopefully? Let's try it. Fire a gun. Overkill, alright. So I think Lulu is slightly weaker than Yuna right now, in terms of magic. When Lulu attacked a plant, she didn't get the overkill that time. When Yuna did this time, and this is the second time attacking a plant, she got the overkill. You know what, I'm gonna check that out real quick. Sorry for taking up a person's time, but... Okay, they're not drastically too far apart from each other, but... Eh. Okay, so let's go right ahead and talk to this thing. Or get into a fight. Be right back. Now, as I said before I was interrupted, we'll talk to this statue.
Summoners that die up here aren't sent to the far plane.
Why not?
Who would send them? They die alone.
So that means...
Many have become fiends, and they may want Yuna's company.
Well, Yuna will be fine.
You're right.
You see, I feel like there's supposed to be some kind of significant thing to talking to those stones. Like some kind of boss fight or something, but it never happens.
Not much has changed in 10 years.
Another thing to note, in that last battle we just had with Machina, you can earn Mega Phoenixes. I don't remember if I saw that before and just didn't mention it, but yeah, this would be a good place to farm for Mega Phoenixes if you don't have enough already. Now, if you come up here and open this chest, Defending Bracer. That should be for Orin, and Stoneproof and Poisonproof. I'm gonna go ahead and equip that. That's actually pretty nice. Oh, we also have to heal some people. Let's have Riku do it since she's not really using MP. There we go. Another battle. Okay. All we have to do is keep following the path. Again, it's really long. You do see a save point on the minimap, or at least you did a second ago. Ah, come. Oh wait, no, this is a new enemy. I'm getting way ahead of myself and thinking too fast. But the new enemy we have is an imp. Again, he casts thunder, weak to water. Waka will kill it. With an overkill, nice. Orin will kill the grenade. And you know what? I'm just gonna attempt to end this battle. It's not gonna work, but... Yeah. I'll just bring in the other four, assuming this guy doesn't attack Orin or Kimari. I'm sorry, Orin or Waka. And no magic counter, so that's good. Bring in Kimari. I forgot if he knows self-destruct. Nah, I'm not gonna chance it. Riku, I'm gonna have her steal, because why not? Then all we have to do is bring in Titus and finish it off with Yuna, probably. And if he even attacks Titus with the magic attack, he's gonna counter, so that's probably not good. Okay, let's bring in Yuna and finish this off. Blizzica! Kill it! Do it! Did not do it! Oh no! What? Okay, so I was worried for nothing. Self-destruct does do damage, it just doesn't wipe out your character, or even your party. I'm a fool! Just keep going along. Come on. Another key thing to note, the encounter rate is ridiculous in this area, but very good for grinding. Hey, what's he doing here?
Greetings, Lady Yuna. My name is Wants.
We have met several times before, right?
Not running today?
I have to carry on my brother's business. You've met him, I think. Owaka the 23rd, merchant extraordinaire.
Wait, you're that guy's brother?
My brother wanted to come help Lady Yuna, but the temple imprisoned him for helping traitors.
They imprisoned him because of us?
He doesn't regret it, though. In fact, he told me, before they took him, don't worry about me, just go help Lady Yuna.
But why would your brother do this for us?
Well, hey, this isn't the time for talking. There's dealing to be done. Welcome to Owaka's.
And for here, you definitely want to buy some weapons. And there's a good reason for that. Titus's weapon, skip it. Yuna's, skip it. Well, yeah, we'll skip it. Double penalty, even though that's technically triple penalty, we'll skip it. Lulu's, on the other hand, we are going to go ahead and take it. I know how wrong that sounds, but if we don't already have what we're looking for... You know what? I actually forgot we're supposed to be capturing fiends, and it just occurred to me how much we kind of messed up. Anyway, go ahead and buy Booster Cactuar. Like I might have mentioned in a previous video, Booster Magic will double the MP usage of any spell, but it will double its effectiveness. So, if Lulu isn't dealing max damage right now, she will be with Magic Booster. And if we have one MP cost on that, she'll deal double the damage with only 2 MP per spell. Skip Trident. Skip Shimmering Blade. Here we go, Survivor. With Alchemy, what that does is it'll double the effectiveness of any potion. If you use Potion, it'll normally heal for 200. That'll double to 400. High Potion for 1,000 doubles to 2,000. Albed Potion, I think it was from 1,000 to 2,000. And Mega Potion from 2,000 to 4,000 for the whole party. So that is very nice. We'll go ahead and equip it. And it comes with Strength plus 10%. So she's already dealing more damage than before. Tetris Shield. I would get that, but eh. Zombie Ward. We don't want Zombie Ward. There's a reason for that soon enough. Tetra Arm Guard. Nah. SOS Shell. No. You know what? Why not? So again, we don't want Zombie Ward just yet. SOS Haste. We can add that ability to what we have, so... yeah.
I will be sure to keep your brother in my prayers.
He's doing the same for you, Lady Yuna.
Thanks.
So yeah, we got some pretty awesome stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and customize it, and we'll be right back. Okay, so I didn't really do a whole lot of customization on armors or weapons. At least not yet. But I think we're still in a pretty good spot. Ugh.
The mountain itself is the trial.
Okay. So right now my recording is currently over an hour. And that might have to be what it is. We're almost there too. There's a treasure chest down there, so I'll cut to when we actually open the chest. I got a bad feeling it'll take up too much time either way. Okay, so here we are. Opening the first chest gets you an HP sphere. Awesome for Orin. And if you come over here, level 4 key sphere. Also nice. I think at this point, I'll meet you at the next save sphere. If there's anything interesting on the way, we'll cut back to it. Otherwise, it'll probably just be fiend after fiend after fiend. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and talk to this statue real quick.
All this way, only to fail. It must have been tough.
And yes, that was pointless. Now, there is another path you can take that's right down there. I don't recall if there's anything even interesting down there, so we'll go up here. We'll hit, not the safe sphere. Just gotta keep pressing on. Can we make it? And yes, we made it. Okay. Unfortunately, given the time, even after I have to cut out everything that just happened, I'm probably going to be over an hour long in this episode. So if I end it here, I might save myself a few minutes. So, yeah, I'll end it here. In between episodes, I'll go back, I'll capture the fiends that I missed, and we'll see what happens. Anyway, thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, for the most part, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye, world!